Good morning, good brothers and good sisters, and praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord, my dear good brothers and good sisters. Rise and shine. It must be what, I don't know what time it is you're getting up, yeah. But we are here to greet you with a very blessed morning. All right?
Yes.
Father, we'll yes. now shoot yeah. the first joke of the morning.
A man went for fishing.
Yes.
After reaching the seashore, he realized that he had forgotten to come with the worms for the hook.
Oh.
And in the state of confusion, he looked around and he found a small snake with one worm in its mouth. So he went and caught hold of the snake and pulled out that worm. And to compensate for what he has taken, he put a few drops of his beer into the mouth of the snake.
Yeah.
Then he started fishing. As he was sitting and fishing, he felt a tug on his trouser. And he looked down. The snake had come with some more worms.
Okay, Father, today's topic is about charity.
Yeah.
The more you go give, the more you receive.
Yeah.
What is that principle and why charity should be done?
Okay, let me quote the Bible.
Yeah.
In the Gospel of St. Luke, chapter 6, verse 38 says, Give and it shall be given unto you. Good measure,
correct,
pressed down and shaken together and running over, shall men give into your bosom.
Yes.
For with the same measure that ye meet withal, it shall be measured to you again.
Yes.
The measure that you give to others, just the measure you shall get it back.
Amen.
Okay. We had the joke also, same thing, isn't
yeah,
it?
Yeah.
More you give, the man gave only 3 drops of beer, and you see the snake brought in so many worms for it. It may be a joke, but it is the reality of life.
Yeah, okay. Yeah.
Now, why should we give? Okay. We all feel happy to receive than to give, because while giving, it hurts us, it pains us. But without realizing, that is the true giving.
Yes.
Okay. Mm-hmm. However, the joy of getting is short-lived.
Yeah, yeah.
Our lives are richer when we share.
Correct.
And that great inner joy comes from helping others to better their lives.
Yeah.
Okay. Truly giving from the heart fills your life with joy and nourishing your soul.
Right.
Giving provides an intrinsic reward that's far more valuable than the gift.
Correct.
As Mahatma Gandhi said, to find yourself, lose yourself in the service of others.
Amen.
So giving takes you out of yourself and allows you to expand beyond earthly limitations.
Correct.
True joy lies in that act of giving without an expectation of receiving something in return.
Correct.
Okay. Of course, there are a lot of researches are done, and if you go through the books, Better Your Life, Better Life and all.
Yes.
So if you go through those series of those books, they always speak of the true way of finding joy, the true happiness of life is found in giving.
Giving.
And therefore Jesus said these words, in giving you shall receive.
Yes.
Now, giving is what kind of giving? It is not something out of the abundance that we have from the material point of view.
Correct.
The giving is always from the abundance of the heart of the person, not from the material possession.
Yes.
The materially possessed people will never give to others if there is no abundance in their heart to give.
Yeah.
Because the materially possessed people, they want to still hoard up and hoard up, hoard up, where in the process of hoarding up, they close themselves to others. They get rotten.
Yeah.
They live in a world of darkness, sinfulness. And ultimately they die and nobody is there
to take it. Even the fear that somebody else can rob it from them. Yeah.
That is what brings the fear that others will rob. And therefore they close themselves from others.
Correct.
And therefore they have no peace of mind.
Yes.
They always live in fear of being robbed, or being attacked.
Yes.
But the man who gives, he has no fear at all. He has the abundance of heart and he'll always give.
Correct.
I remember a story shared by one priest that during his studies, as a priest, he was living in a village in a small house.
Mm-hmm.
And one day a thief entered into his house And he was looking for the things, but this priest had no money, nothing else, except his books was the only treasure he had.
Yeah.
And when the thief was, you know, pulling out the things, the priest was awake and he saw the thief. He said, "My dear friend, what are you doing?" He said, "I come to rob you." "Don't attack me. You have come to rob, right?"
"Yeah."
"Take whatever you want. I have all these books. That's the only wealth. I'm a student."
"Yeah." "Okay.
Money I don't have, but take this." The robber changed and he became a priest, joined the seminary and became a priest.
Oh. Yeah.
So, you see, the giving, he said he was generously gave the books. He was ready to give, but the man did not take it.
Yeah.
But you know, it brought a change in the life of the person.
Correct.
Now, in the world, we see there are so many charitable institutions, okay? There are two things about these charitable institutions, what I have to say. One thing is the positive aspect of it.
Yeah.
Now, the institutions are run, but the institution itself does not generate the income to help the needy people.
Correct.
The resources come from people outside, those who are generous, okay?
Yes.
They just give.
Correct. Correct.
They give because they see there is somebody who is in need.
Yes.
Therefore, they give.
Correct. Correct.
Not because they have, but they see somebody suffering.
And they give.
In order to alleviate their suffering, to raise them up from their miserable status of life. Therefore, they give.
Right.
And they give generously. These institutes or the individuals who are involved, they generously work. And they give their time. They sacrifice so much. Yes. They would have given their time for their family and all. But there are also where families themselves involved in giving. Okay,
yes.
Because they find true joy in giving. Therefore, they don't limit at all. Day and night, they are at the service of other people. They give and they give and they give.
Yes.
Okay. There's also the negative side of it. The institutions, when I said, there are also people, those who do not want to work, they find this as a work and they start some charitable institutes, get the funds, spend 5%, keep 95% for themselves for their luxurious life.
I know
there are certain people, they make the video of somebody's sick in the hospital, somebody's house is falling, somebody is met with accident, somebody is having some trouble and all. They make the video and put it because there are many people who are ready to help others.
Images, yes.
But what happens is these persons, they take the money. There are 10 people come forward to help, okay?
Yeah.
He takes the money from every person.
Correct.
But he gives the money of only one person is needed for that people.
Right.
Of the 9 people, entire thing is kept for himself and his selfish motive. Maybe he may be using a little thing here and there.
Yeah.
But the persons, there are persons in the society who are misusing this
of course
good work of charity for the wrong purposes. Okay.
For making profit for themselves.
Yeah. Now, we have to understand the evils that are existing around us. Therefore, we have to learn the true giving. True giving is always painful and hurt. We should give till it hurts. As Jesus Christ gave till it hurt him. He gave himself totally on the cross for our salvation. Therefore, our giving is a participation in the sacrificial death of Jesus Christ.
Yes.
And therefore, giving, I said, because giving is not just I take some money and give to some institutes, what he said, which can be used properly or could be misused.
Yes.
Therefore,
I
should involve. Therefore, it hurts me to know whether the situation is right, the person is truly a needy person. Because once somebody knows there is somebody is giving, like in the church, there are so many people coming and taking.
Yeah.
And we cannot get into all the situations. There are people come and steal, rob.
Oh.
Other day, one man gave us false stories and took a huge amount of money.
My God.
So, there are so many people telling lies. And so, the giving hurts because we have to get into the person to find out, verify the causes, and then we have to give the right person.
Yeah.
Therefore, it hurts to study. But we otherwise, because somebody came and asked, I give, finished. That's not true giving.
No.
But it should hurt us too.
Yes,
pain.
Yes.
And in what way we give? Giving is always not from the abundance, but giving from what we have. Sharing. Therefore, it is called sharing.
Yeah.
So, I sacrifice something for myself and give to another. That is the true charity.
Amen. So, my dear brothers and sisters, be very careful. When you are doing charity, find out how genuine the person to whom you are helping is. Might be institution, might be people, individually. But many put up a very, very different picture. They beg, it's become a business today. Especially We are breeding such type of people in the church compounds who come to just see who's growing well, and they want to take money out of them, you know. So let's pray, and let us pray that God shows us the right people whom we can help. But charity is good if it goes to the right person.
Yes.
Father, let's pray.
God Almighty Father, we thank and praise you for giving yourself totally through your Son Jesus Christ.
Yes, Lord.
Help us that we may be generous like your Son in reaching out to others, but give us the wisdom to do our charity in a right manner.
Yes, Lord.
We ask this in the name of Jesus the Lord.
Amen. Amen. Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit.
Amen. Amen.
So before I say go in peace, I want to tell you, going back to the inner healing, there is a beautiful movie in Hindi, those who can understand the Hindi language.
Yes.
The movie called Dear Jindagi. Watch that movie, and it has got the right aspect of counseling also.
Yes.
And also how the dreams come to our aid in while overcoming our inner wounds. For the inner healing, the dreams also support us.
Yeah.
And it has been beautifully brought out, and I would advise anybody to watch that movie. It is one of the good movies that I liked, Dear Zindagi. So have a beautiful day. God bless you.
Amen. Amen.